Hey, what's up everyone? In this video, we're going to go through 6 easy to follow steps to get your WordPress content ranking faster. So if you're new to this, this video is perfect for you. Let's see if this sounds familiar. You have a great website, a fantastic product or service, and lots of content ideas. You've even started posting on your blog regularly, but it doesn't seem to be getting the amount of traffic you want. Now, we've all been here, and it's a problem many of us face regularly, especially with new websites. It's more than likely that the content you're adding to your website is not getting picked up by search engines in the way you want. In other words, it's not ranking. There's a word we love to hate, rank or ranking, and yes, it does mean exactly what it says. It's your content versus the world, and the search engines get to decide where your position is in that long list of search results. Don't be discouraged though, because the next few steps in this video are going to give you a fantastic boost and help you get your content ranking faster. The first step that we're going to take is to install all-in-one SEO on our WordPress site. It's a fantastic SEO plugin packed full of features, and to unlock its full potential, we'll be adding the premium version of the plugin to our site and setting it up. Let's do it. So the first thing we need to do in this video is come to the all-in-one SEO website. So the link for that is in the description below. It's also up on the screen right now. To get all-in-one SEO, all we need to do is come to this green button right here, click on that. That's going to then take us to the pricing page. There are various pricing plans available depending on the features that you need. We're going to go with the Pro pricing plan. That's because it covers all the features that we are going to look at in this video. But once you've decided the plan that suits you and suits your website, go ahead and press the Get Started button right there. And then that'll take you through setting up an account. And then once you've done that, log into your account and I'll meet you there. So now you've logged into your all-in-one SEO account, what we're going to do here is we're going to copy the license key and download all-in-one SEO to our computer and then install that on our WordPress site. So from here, we just go to the link right here, click on that. And that's going to bring us to this section, and you can see the license key is right here. You just click the little clipboard icon right there and it'll copy it to your computer. So I've copied that to my computer, and now I'm just going to click the green button here to download all-in-one SEO. So once you've downloaded all-in-one SEO, then log into your WordPress site. So now we've logged into our WordPress site, we're going to install all-in-one SEO. And to do that, we just head to plugins here on the left-hand side, hover over that, and then click on add new. And then we're going to head up to the upload plugins button up here. Just click on that. That's going to open this little box right here. All we need to do is either click this button to choose the file from your computer, but I'm just going to head down here and grab the file I've just downloaded and drag it and drop it on there. Then just hit the install now button to install the plugin. And once that's installed, then click the blue activate plugin button right there just to activate the plugin. So now the plugin's been installed and activated, we are brought to the all-in-one SEO dashboard. As you can see, there is a little red notice right here to say that no license key is currently being entered in this pro version of all-in-one SEO. So let's take care of that now and click this add your license key now link right here. And that's brought us to the general settings. And as you can see, there's a license key section right here. And all you need to do is paste in that license key that you just copied from your account page. Once you've done that, then just click the green connect button and that will then connect your site. And the next step is to launch the setup wizard. So you've just clicked this green button right here. And what the setup wizard is going to do is going to take us through a few different steps to help us set up all-in-one SEO in the quickest and most efficient way possible. Just click the Let's Get Started button right there. So the first thing it asks us is what category best describes our website. We're currently using an online store website as the demo for this video. So I'm just going to click on online store. And if I scroll down a little bit, we can now choose how our homepage title is added. So we can change this if we want. And also our homepage meta description, we can change that as well. All this can be changed at a later time in the plugin. Just click save and continue. Now it's asking us about our site information. So whether we're a person or organization, the details for our store, whether we want to upload any logos or anything, and also whether we want to add any of our social profiles. So we can do all that and then click save and continue. Now it's asking what features we want enabled. And because we chose a e-commerce store, it's already gone ahead and recommended a few features and turned them on automatically. But we can go through and turn them off if we don't want them, or we can choose to add new ones as well. So I'm going to leave it as it is. I'm just going to click save and continue. So on this page right here is to do with search appearance. We're being asked to look at these settings to make sure that they're correct for what we want to show up on Google. So we've got the Google snippet preview right here. We can click on that and edit the meta title and description from there. Below that, there's a setting right here to tell Google whether our site is currently under construction and we don't want it to be indexed yet, or whether it's a live site and it can index our pages straight away. Also, we've got a toggle here to include all post types in the indexing as well. And we can see that our sitemap is enabled by default. If we scroll down, we've got a couple of other options here, so you can choose what suits you there. And then we can click save and continue. And now we get this page just to say that all in one SEO wizard is finished and our site is now SEO ready. So we can click the finish setup and go to dashboard button here. So now we've done that with the setup wizard, we're now back on the all-in-one SEO dashboard. So we've got the all-in-one SEO overview, which we can choose different post types. So we can choose posts, pages, and products, and all-in-one SEO will give us a breakdown of what needs improving, what's okay, what's good, and what needs focus key phrases, for example. We also have an SEO score, which is 81 out of 100 at the moment, so that's pretty good, but we have got some issues right here. And we can click on this link right here to look at the complete site audit checklist, and then we can make improvements that all-in-one SEO has suggested. And if we scroll down just a little bit, we can also see there's some quick links to some of the features in all-in-one SEO. So it's a great place to start improving SEO on your WordPress site. Now we have all-in-one SEO set up on our website, let's make sure we can monitor the website's performance by setting up Google Search Console. So from here, all we need to do is copy the URL of our website and then head over to Google Search Console. The link for Google Search Console is in the description below. I'll also put it up on screen as well. So then once you're on Google Search Console, you'll see this screen, and all you need to do is press the Start Now button right here. And then as long as you're logged into the Google account you want connected to your WordPress site, then you should see this screen. Otherwise, it'll ask you to log in to your Google account. And then once you see this screen, you've got two options. The option that we're going to use is the URL prefix option right here. So all you need to do is paste in your domain URL right there. And then once you've pasted that in, just click the continue button right there. Now it's going to say it's verifying the property. And now when you see this screen, what we have to do is we have to verify the ownership of this property. And there's a really easy way we can do that by using all-in-one SEO as well. All you need to do is you choose the HTML tag option right here, and then just copy this tag by clicking this copy button, and then head back to your WordPress dashboard. And now we're back in the WordPress dashboard. We'll just head to the general settings underneath all-in-one SEO right here. And then when we're under the general settings, you'll see there's a tab for webmaster tools right here. Just click on that. And the webmaster tools verification method we're going to use is the Google Search Console method. So just click on that. And then all we need to do is just paste in the code that we just copied right here. Don't forget to click save changes to save those, and then head back to Google Search Console. And then once you're back in Google Search Console, all you need to do under the HTML tag section is just click verify. And now you can see we get a ownership verified message right here, and we can now see that we have our site connected to Google Search Console. Let's talk about XML sitemaps. They may sound complex, but they are simply just a way for search engines like Google to discover all the content you have on your website quickly and easily. It tells Google what content you want it to look at. So to add sitemaps to Google Search Console, it couldn't be easier, especially with all-in-one SEO. So all we need to do is just head over to sitemaps under all-in-one SEO over here on the left-hand side, click on that. So now we're under sitemaps and we're under the general sitemap tab right here. And we can see that our general sitemap is enabled by default through all-in-one SEO. And now all we need to do is open the sitemap in a new tab and then copy the end of the URL to use in Google Search Console. You'll see what that looks like in Google Search Console, but I'll also give you an indication on the screen as well. So we're going to open it in a new tab, and then I'm going to copy the sitemap XML, which is at the end of my URL, and then I'm going to head to Google Search Console. And now we're under Google Search Console for that website. You can see on the left-hand side here under indexing, there is a sitemaps option. Just click on that. And now it's asking us to add a new sitemap. So you can see that we have our website domain right there. And then at the end of this is the part that we've just copied from the URL when we opened the sitemap in a new tab. So I'm just going to paste that in here. And then all you need to do once you've pasted that there is click on the blue submit button. So now we've got a message to let us know that that sitemap has been submitted successfully. And there is another type of sitemap that search engines recommend you submit in your Search Console, and that is the RSS sitemap. So we're going to head back to our WordPress dashboard and take a look at that. So now we're back in our WordPress dashboard, and next to the general sitemap tab, there are other tabs as well, and the RSS sitemap tab is right here. Click on that. You can see that this is enabled as well by default through All-in-One SEO. We're just going to go through the exact same process, and we're just going to open the sitemap up in a new tab. And the reason that this sitemap is really important to search engines is because it contains all the details for your blog posts, products, etc. So once you update a post or you post a new post, then the search engine will be able to check your RSS sitemap and find that content much more quickly than just going through your general sitemap. So it's a great way of getting those faster ranking results. I'm just going to copy the end of the URL right here and then head back to Google Search Console. And now back on Google Search Console, underneath the sitemap section right here, we'll just paste in the RSS sitemap. I'm going to submit that, and we can see that that was submitted successfully. As you can see, it might take a while for Google to update the status of the sitemap, but it should update within a couple of minutes. And once that's updated, Google will now use your sitemaps to find newer content quicker. We have now taken the steps needed for a search engine to be able to discover our content, but there is some work to do on the actual content to help it rank faster in higher positions. The main three areas we're going to look at here are the meta title, the meta description, and keywords for your content. So to optimize our content, like I said, there are a couple of things that we can do with the meta title and description of pages and posts. To show you what I mean, I'm going to go to a post right now. So I'm going to head over to posts here on the left-hand side and just click on that. Then I'm going to choose the top post here that I have. I'm just going to click on that. And what this page is this is a blog post that's been written for the site, and it's to cover the top 7 desktop speakers for video. So we've created a little bit of content here because we believe there's some interest from people that will be using our site. So to optimize this content, what we need to do is we need to think about the keyword or key phrase that we want to rank for. And what essentially that means is the word or phrase that someone will search on Google to find this content. Now, usually this is done before you write a blog post, so you'll have an idea of keywords that you want to rank for and then create the content around that. So what we've done is we've decided that our key phrase is top 7 desktop speakers. So now we have our key phrase, we now can take a look at our meta title and description to make sure that that key phrase appears in them to help this content rank higher and faster. So to do that, we're going to use All-in-One SEO. So we're going to come past block editor right here. We're going to scroll down into the All-in-One SEO settings, and underneath the general tab, you can see right here, it says snippet preview. And this is a preview of what the meta title and description will look like in the search results. Below that, we can see that there's the post title right here. And at the moment, the default is it's pulling the title of the blog post and then the site title, which you can see just here. And then below that is the meta description. And at the moment, it's just pulling the post excerpt. So it's pulling all the text content below the heading into the meta description right here. And as you can see on both of these, they have a maximum recommended characters. So currently the title is completely fine. It's within the maximum recommended characters, but the post excerpt is way above the recommended characters. So in the search engine, someone might want to read that to kind of find out a little bit more what the page is about, but they can't because it's not constructed in a way in which they can see all the information. So as I said, our key phrase is top 7 desktop speakers. And currently we can see All-in-One SEO is indicating a 77 out of 100 score for this blog post at the moment. Let's see if we can improve that. So I'm going to leave the post title as it is because it's got the key phrase in it. And then I'm going to come down to the post excerpt. I'm going to remove that from the meta description. And then I'm just going to paste in some content that I've written for this description. I've added that in there, and then you can see underneath in the snippet preview, it now fits and people can read and make a decision on whether they want to view this content. There is another really cool feature right here as well with All-in-One SEO. You can add your focus key phrase to this box right here, and then it will give you some recommendations and information about this blog post. So I'm just going to copy the key phrase, I'm going to add it to the box, and then I'm going to just click add focus key phrase. And there you can see it's given me 100 out of 100 for the focus key phrase, We've also got an 85 out of 100 now. We're in the green in this section. Next up, we're going to add some internal links to our content. This is a really important part to help search engines discover new content faster. So let's do that. So we're back on the WordPress site and we're back with the blog post that we've just been working on for the meta title and description. So we know what our keywords are for this and we can see in all-in-one SEO at the bottom that it had a recommendation in the page analysis to add internal links and some external links as well. So there isn't any currently on the page. We're going to change that right now. So I'm going to scroll back up to the content. And on this page, I can see that we recommend the top 7 desktop speakers for videos and we give a list of individual products that people might want to check out. Now, when you're building your blog posts up and things like that, you might be thinking of other parts of the website that you can incorporate into the blog post so you can link to. And what that will do is create an amazing network of links on your website for people to follow, but also the search engine to follow to figure out exactly what your site's about and the kind of content on it. So what we're going to do here, we're just going to add a link to this product here. So we've got this product on the site in the online store. So I'm just going to highlight the text and then click the link button right here. And then all we need to do is search for the page that we're looking for. That's come up with our product right here. I'm just going to click on that. And now that is linking to the product on the site. So if you click update to save those changes, and then if we scroll down, we'll now see in the page analysis, we have some internal links on the page. And also it's given our all-in-one SEO score a boost as well. Another great way to get more people heading to the new content you create is to share it on social networks. With all-in-one SEO, you can make sure your content looks fantastic when you share it. Here's how to do that. Go to the page or post that you want to share. Once you're in the editor for that post or page, scroll down to the all-in-one SEO settings. And next to the general tab right here is the social tab. You just click on that. And this is going to give you a preview of what this page or post will look like if it's shared on Facebook and Twitter. You can use these two tabs here to see what it looks like. So at the moment, it doesn't look very good on Twitter and Facebook isn't much better either. So with all-in-one SEO, we can control the title, the description, the image, everything that's being shown. We can choose to just show the post title. We can choose to add in a new description. So as you can see in the preview, it's changed those there. We've also got the option to change the image. So we can change it to the featured image of the post. So that looks much better already. And if we've got a video that we want to insert in there, we can put the video URL and we have other options as well. And once you're happy with how that looks, you can click update and that will save the changes. And there you have a fantastic looking preview of what sharing this content will look like on social networks. So that's the 6 steps to getting your content ranking faster. But now you're on a roll, why not jump in and check out how to use Monster Insights to track all the traffic that will be heading to your site. It works seamlessly with all-in-one SEO to help you grow your website. If you've enjoyed this video, let us know in the comments below. We are more than happy to answer any questions you may have too. And make sure you subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.